Welcome to video number 28 on working with train controller. In the previous video we had a look at a flagman that was triggered by a so-called combi group combined with train description, and we were planning to use that to make a counter of the amount of trains that are actually running. Well, let's have a look how we can do that. Let's first have a look at what a counter actually is and how it works. Let's make an example. Over here we have the station Inglenook, and I would like to have a counter that counts how many trains are here in the station. Is that really useful? Well, not if you have only three tracks, because it's quite obvious in one blink of an eye you see how many trains are on. But suppose you have a hidden yard, a shadow station with 12 tracks. And you can see the trains over here on your switchboard, but if there are 6 or 7 spread around, you probably need to start counting them yourself. So a counter could be helpful then. Let's create that counter. That is done by clicking over here selecting the counter from the switches drop down and place one over there. Accidentally hit it twice. What can we do with the counter? Well, let's double click it and let's see what happens. We can give it a name. Let me give it Inglenook shorthand name. Then in the counter tab we can say when is the counter on and when is the counter off and where should it start. Well, our counter should start at 0, but what does that on off mean? Well, actually a counter is also a switch, and it switches itself on. In this case I'm going to put it on 3. As soon as all the tracks are occupied, I want that counter to be on, and with less than 3 I want it to be off. Do I need an operation? We can give it an operation. That means what happens if the counter goes on. But I don't need that. I'm going to use a flagman to signal that my counter is on, and that's all. So I do not need an operation over here. Let's get out of here. Let's click OK. My counter is now available, and it will put itself on as soon as it reaches the count of 3. Well, I'm going to use a flagman to signal that, this flagman over here. It is going to have a trigger. Well, let me first give it a name. This is Inglenook Full. And the trigger is my counter. Where is my counter? Ah, here is my Inglenook counter. And I'm going to add that. But I have to put it in the on state. And this is the on state. So my flagman over here is going to be raised when my Inglenook counter reaches the count of 3. Now I need to operate the counter itself. Oh, let's go back to it. And we see there is not a trigger tab in here. You might have expected that. How can I count up or count down? Yeah, there could have been a trigger tab here, but there is not. So apparently we need to put it as an operation in another element. And I want to count if the blocks are current, if there's a train on the block, but unfortunately a block itself cannot have an operation. I need an additional flagman for that. Let me quickly place 3. I need one for all the tracks, and let's edit number 3 over here. Let me quickly give it a name, Inglenook 3. Oh, that was not an I. Inglenook 3. And the trigger is that the block is current. Well, let me first find the block. Block Inglenook 3. I'm adding it now, and I'm going to say it needs to be current. I'm going to zoom out, otherwise maybe the view is switching a lot up and down. Okay, let's do Inglenook 2. Flagman, the trigger is that block number 2 should be the current block. Oh, I forgot something. I only need to count up. This is only the trigger. No, that's good. I have not forgotten anything. The trigger is good. I'm confusing myself. Inglenook 1, yeah, there it is. The block to add is block 1 is the current block, and the name is Inglenook 1. And now what I forgot is I need to operate the counter. So let's do that for number 1 now that we are here. The operation that I want to take place is that my Inglenook counter that I'm now going to add should count up if the flagman is green, but if the flagman is red, then it should count down. And I can select that over here. I can also select to reset the counter even. So my number 1 is done. My number 2, I have not yet finished its operations. So in the green state I am going to count up, yes, and in the red state I'm going to count down. Yeah, that is also correct. And the number 3, in the green state I want to count up, yes, and in the red state I want to count down. Well, this should do it. So what have we done? As soon as there is a train in a block, the flagman that is related to it will become green and it will increment the counter. And if a train leaves again, it will decrement the counter. If the counter is at 3, it will light this flag over here to signal that the station is full. Let's put it to the test. I'm curious. Over here I have this train. I'm going to drive it in. And let's see what happens. Yeah, this flagman is raising its flag and the counter is at 1. Well, that is perfect. That is what we wanted, isn't it? Yes. So let's put in another train, drive it in slowly and nicely. Yeah, there my second flagman is lit and my counter is at 2. Let's put in another train. Yes, the counter is at 3 and my station full flagman is also raised now. So what we see is we can trigger a counter via a flagman or via a switch, or anything that has an operation can trigger the counter up or down or a reset even. And the counter itself is acting as a switch, and we used that to turn on this flagman. That's how a counter can be put to good use. Well, now that we know all this, we can go back to our running train flagman over here. How did that work again? Let's double click it. This is my 126 train, that's the blue intercity. If I double click it, we can see in the trigger there is this combi group with all the blocks that are on the layout inside it. And over here we have a train description, and that train description said Intercity 126 is driving. Yeah, and that train description itself was defined over here in the train menu with the train descriptions. There it is. The properties say the train should have a speed of minimum 1 km/h and it is valid only for the 126 intercity. So that's how those flagmen were made, and it monitors if a train is actually driving. And now if we look at the operation of the flagman, what it does, it counts the train counter up or down, as we see over here. And that's all that is needed to have a running train counter. Well, let's put it to the test also. Get out of edit mode. Let me put this train over there and let me start 2 schedules, this one and this one. Yeah, it started, but the train are not moving yet. This one or that one will go. Yeah, there it goes. Yeah, my counter is at 1, as we can see. Yeah, there the blue one also goes, and my counter is at 2. And that is because these 2 flagmen are lit, and they are lit because of the helpful use of train descriptions. Well, as you may also have noticed, this counter over here, that is a fancy Nixie tube, that is counting also these trains here at Inglenook. Look what happens if I remove a few trains. It is going to a different state. What is this? How can this be so large while a normal counter is just one icon? Well, this is what we call an extended accessory. And that will be the subject of the next video. No, probably the second next video, because first what we are going to have a look at, how do we get this schedule counter over here that counts the amount of running schedules. It is not done via Flagman. It is done via so-called schedule start and stop operations. And that will be the subject of the next video. And then the second next video will be on extended accessories. Maybe see you back there. Thank you for watching and bye bye.